Hello everyone, this is Om and welcome to Civil Raja, your gateway to future. So guys, in today's class, we are going to learn for the load calculation of walls. So for the calculation of the wall loads, what we need height of the wall, then the thickness of the mortar, then the thickness of the brickwork, and the density of the brickwork, then the density of mortar. So a few things like this we need, and how to assemble all these things to calculate the wall load, that we are going to discuss in this lecture. So that can be done also by the pen and paper method, or you can say you can use the Word, but I am personally using Excel. Why so? Because if you are framing something in Excel, then you can just easily change the values for your particular project and you can get the desired result. So I have already prepared the Excel sheet and it took me almost half an hour. So this is the lump sum time that you will also take if you want to just make such an Excel sheet. So don't ask me for that Excel sheet. Just try to make it on your own. Okay. Now, I am just going to share that with you. So for that, you can see this is my Excel sheet. And you can see I have prepared it for basically calculation of the masonry wall load. So what we are going to do with it, we are calculating the wall load for the red brick. So first thing that we need is floor to floor height. So I am going with a 10 feet 6 inches of the floor to floor height. Now, if it is the floor to floor height, then the depth of the beam can be considered according to your need. In my case, it was 300 mm. So I'm just going with 300 mm. And then the wall height will come 3.2 minus 0.3. That is floor to floor height minus depth of beam. And that will eventually come to 2.9 meters. So all these things or all these values are in meters. And over here in this column, you can see different type of units. Okay. Now the thickness of the brickwork for the 10 inches wall is 225 mm, which is eventually 0.225 meter. Okay, now from where we are getting this? We are getting this from this standard coordinate size of the brickwork, that is 225 mm multiplied by 112.5 mm multiplied by 75 mm, which are length, depth, and height respectively. Okay, so you can also call it as a 9 inch, 4.5 inch, and 3 inch. Okay, so that is ultimately these things are. Now we can also check for over here, according to 875 part one, I say 875 part one, table one, the unit of the unit weight of the brick is 16 kilonewton per meter cube, and unit weight of mortar is 20 kilonewton per meter cube. So for that, we can simply go to our IS code, and over there we can check for IS 875 part one. So over here you can see this is IS 875 part one, and this is basically for the dead loads. But if you want to learn the other IS codes, then you can simply find it over here. Like the part one is for the dead loads, part two is for imposed load, and when we are applying some live load, then you can refer this imposed load part. Now if you are dealing with somewhere area where the wind speed is too high, or you are going for the high ridge building, then you can go for wind loads also. Then the snow load is just for the special places where you can find the snow falling over there, like in Uttarakhand or Jammu and Kashmir if you are in India, or if you are from other place than India, then you can just find according to your locality whether it is required or not. Then you can go for the IS 875 part 5 for the special loads and the loads combination. Now, for the calculation of the wall loads, this is our point of concern, that is the table 1, which is for unit weight of the building materials. And in this table, at point 13, you will find the bricks. Okay, so here is the common burnt clay bricks, which is having the unit weight ranging from 15.70 to 18.85 kilonewton per meter cube. So I am considering a digit in between this. So it is 16 kilonewton per meter cube. And then again, we have the unit weight of the cement mortar, which is 20.40. So for ease of calculation, I will go with 20 kilonewton per meter cube. Okay. So here is the Excel sheet. and I am going with the unit of the unit weight of the brick as 16 kN per meter cube and unit weight of mortar as 20 kN per meter cube. Now, if you are willing to calculate the wall load for the exterior wall of 10 inches, then what you are going to need? You need the wall height. So wall height will be how much? Floor to floor height minus the depth of beam. So in my case, floor to floor height is 3.2 meter and the depth of beam is 0.3 meter. So wall height will be 3.2 minus 0.3, that is 2.9. So I will consider the wall height multiplied by thickness of brickwork. So this is like a 10 inches wall. So I will go with the highest dimension, that is almost 9 inches of the brick, that is 225 mm. So this will be the thickness of the brickwork. And then we will convert it into the meters for the multiplication purpose. Then the unit weight of the brick. So this is coming 16 kN per meter cube. So on total, if you will multiply these three units, then it will give you a value in kN per meter. You can also check it by the calculations. Now, this will be added with the wall height multiplied by thickness of the mortar plus, multiplied by a unit weight of the mortar. Now, thickness of the mortar is again a point to be considered. So I will just tell you a few things. Like for the external walls, the thickness of the mortar varies from 15 mm to 22 mm. Okay, so I'm just going with the 15 mm over here. Now, if you want to go for the internal wall, then it varies from 12 mm to 18 mm. Okay, that depends upon the requirement. So I'm going with the 12 mm. So 12 mm is more than enough. That is almost half inch. And the outer plaster is almost 1 inch. Okay, so that is the basic consideration. And that depends upon the requirement of your project. So whatever you are providing for the plaster. Now I am considering the inner plaster as 12 mm thick and outer plaster as 15 mm thick. Now, if I'm just considering an external wall, so the external wall will have outer plaster on one side. However, on one side, it will have inner plaster because it is coming inside the house. So it will be 15 mm plus 12 mm, that is 27 mm, which will ultimately convert to 0.027 meter if I'm converting that in different unit. Now, if I am talking about the internal walls, then it will come up with inner plaster on both the sides. So that will be 12 mm plus 12 mm. So according to that, you can just consider the thickness of the plaster and it will ultimately add you to the wall load. So you have to consider this. Now, if I'm talking about the parapet wall, okay, then the height of the parapet wall is a little less. It is not as high as a normal wall. So it is almost 3 feet 6 inches, or in some cases it is 3 feet also. Some people just go for on the parapet wall, they go for balcony design of aluminium or irons also. So that load may vary from project to project. But if I am considering a 3 inches wall, or you can say that will be 4 inches wall actually, but the brickwork will be taken from the 3 inches side. So according to that, the parapet wall load has been calculated in this actual sheet. I will also show you, and I will also change the dimensions so that you can have the ease of the calculation. Now over here you can see that in the Excel sheet, you can see that for the exterior wall load, I have already explained the formula. So you can see I have set the same formula for this box over here, and it is coming up to 12.006 kN per meter cube, which is approx 12 kN per meter. Okay, now over here, the thickness of the brickwork for the 5 inches wall. So I'm just going to consider this thickness, that is 112.5 mm, as that is converted over here. Then the thickness of the mortar will be 12 plus 12 because it is an internal wall. So it will be 0.024 meter. So it will ultimately come up to this. So again, the formula has been used is the same as this one. Now for the height of the parapet wall. So it can be 3 feet 6 inches, which will come around 1 meter. But if it you are using 3 foot wall, then you can also change the unit. Over here, I have also set a formula over here. Like I can just convert the unit just to show you easily. So if it is a 3 foot wall, so it will be 12 into 3, 36 inches. So it will come around 0.9144. And if it is 3 foot 6 inches wall, then it will come 36 plus 6, that is 1.0068. Okay, so that is the value that we are getting. So like that, you can simply do the calculations over here. And thickness of the brickwork is again 75 mm, which is coming from here, as you can see. Now, the next thing is the thickness of the mortar. So it is an external one on the both sides. So we can go for 30 mm of the thickness altogether, 15 plus 15. So it will bring you to the wall load of this. Now, suppose I am changing this height. Okay, I'm just making it 0.9 meters. Then ultimately, it is changing everything over here. Okay. And it is very easy for our calculations. Now, if I am changing this height, okay, so I'm just going with a 3 meter high floor, then you can see all the values have been changed. So this is the benefit if you are using like Excel sheet, you have can easily change things. So guys, I think all the things are clear over here in this Excel sheet. If you want to take a screenshot, I will just pause for a minute. Take the screenshot. Now, take the screenshot of this one also, and you can simply make this Excel sheet. Don't ask for this Excel sheet to me, because you can simply go ahead and make it, because if you will make it, then your concepts will be clarified to you. Okay, so it took me around half an hour to make this Excel sheet. So that is all when I had to arrange each and everything. So it will take you almost 20 minutes to prepare all these things, because now you have understood the concept behind that. Now guys, this was on the request of Suri Prakash, which is one of our viewer. So if you have any kind of question, you can simply leave that in the comment section, or you can WhatsApp me on the number given in the description, and I will definitely get back to you via these types of the videos. And if you have liked this session, hit the like button, share it with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to our channel Civil Raja, and keep learning and keep asking your doubts. Thank you.